Hey guys.
Has there ever been a moment in your life that you felt like you've had this type of chest pain? You know, this feeling where your heart was beating ridiculously strong or hard? Have you ever asked yourself, is my heart beating normally? Well, in this video, I'm going to be giving you an intro about heart rate, how to measure it, the factors that affect it, and the signs that you need to be concerned about. Come in right up.
Hey guys, Aman here from Heart Limits, the channel that brings you the relevant facts, the proper tips and tools, and the lifestyle changes that are necessary, if you do it right, to keep you within your extended heart limits. The human heart, generally speaking, is a pump. And I'm pretty sure there's a couple of things that comes into your mind when I say the word pump. So of course there's things such as... And also things such as...
And is generally a size of a human fist.
Well, I'm not really sure if this is average. Usually they state it that way when you say it's generally the size of a human fist. So it depends, is this average or are you average? And the plot thickens. Dun, dun, dun!
And the speed at which our heart beats is called heart rate. You know, a bit like...
Or... Something like...
Heart rate is commonly understood as pulse. And by pulse, when you measure it, it's normally called as BPM. Or what most people confuse with as beats per minute as a music term. Well, the thing is, it's actually connected but different at the same time. With music, it is a measurement of tempo. And by tempo, I mean at the speed at which patterns play back. You know, easily manageable with this device. I actually forgot the name, what it's called. You know, that. Usually when you play the piano or something, so you stay on the right beat, you know, the right tempo, then. I think it's called a monotone or something. Anyway, but with the heart, it's actually the measurement of the number of beats that your heart makes per minute.
Heart rate not only helps you monitor your fitness level, but also it actually helps you be aware in cases that there's a possibility that there might be actually something wrong with you. It can help you spot certain possibly complicated heart problems that you actually might be suffering.
So the first question is, where do you measure your heart rate? Well, to simplify, there's actually two possible ways you can do this. One is doing it the manual way, and the second is the automated way, or as you could say, the digital way.
So, with the manual way, the best places to measure, you have your wrist, neck pulse, you have, you know, inside your elbow, and you also have the top of your foot,
somewhere around here.
But for me, to be honest, the easiest place to find it, manually speaking, is actually at your neck. And it's actually the most convenient and not stupid looking one. Imagine you start running, and while you're running, and you just take off your shoe, and like, oh, I gotta measure my fucking heart rate. And you're like, what the fuck? Okay, there's a guy just staring at me. Anyway, so to measure your heart rate. And imagine if you run around and you start measuring from your here, and you're like, right, I look at my watch to keep track, and I'm gonna keep running. Right, this is not convenient. People might think you're like some type of addict or something. For automated, on the other hand, the list is just mind-blowing, you know. They even have ways where you can measure your heart rate by putting this thing inside your ear. You also have these things that you put on your forehead. You have this, you know, basically this... technically high-tech since it's a watch that monitors my heart rate. You also have these chest straps. You know, it's so diverse in the automatic that, you know, it's just mind-blowing how much technology is evolving. I would really consider probably three. First, if you really want, you know, decent enough accuracy, you would probably go for your chest strap. But the problem with the chest strap is, you know, you can't really just look because normally there's no screen on it. So you have to connect it with a mobile device just so that you can monitor the results. And for me, it's the best for the reason that if you do sports, you know, you're moving around, it's usually the one that stays the most in place. Problem is, of course, once you sweat a lot, it becomes, you know, just messy down there. Second for me would probably be the index finger, that clip that you can put. That one's pretty decent as well, but of course if you do sports, you know, it's just strange, you're running around, you're like, clip it on my finger. You know, it's not as convenient as what most people would think. And third would be the wrist. So, you know, you've got devices from the big companies, you know, like Fitbit, you got Apple and all that, but you know, a study show there are limitations to the wrist type of, you know, automated heart rate measurement devices. So per se that when you use a wrist device, you have to really, really make sure that it's on really tight, because the problem is your hand has a lot of motion. And even though you're not aware, there are times that, you know, it just moves around automatically as you speak, just like, hello, what I'm doing. And with those motions, it actually doesn't give a very, very accurate response. And other than that, it's also the technology that's involved, because usually they have this type of sensor. And so many times when I wore, you know, a wrist type of watch, it just moves around too much. And when I start to check, all right, what's my, you know, my beats per minute? And I'm like, fuck, it didn't even recognize my wrist. So of course, you also need to ask yourself, what is the normal heart rate? Well, you know, I'm gonna go more into detail about this in the future videos, but just to simplify it for now, during rest, the normal heart rate should technically be around 60 to 100 beats per minute. Well, you know, in some articles, it's around 60 to 90. In some, if you're more sports-minded, you can go even as low as 40. Not just sports-minded, of course, I mean like fit in that regard. So I just saw like a football pitch type of thing, so I just can't help myself, so wait, I just want to kick some balls. So it's not really a real football pitch, but it's got all the grass and shit, so I just want to kick the ball a bit. Almost hit my camera. Holy shit.